Good morning. Welcome to worship on this Passion Weekend. This morning, the choir and Sunday school kids present the story of Christ's passion, death, and crucifixion on the cross. We invite you back to hear how the story ends, of course, next Sunday. There are several other activities and worship opportunities throughout the week, Bible studies and things relevant to the Holy Week that it is. You're invited to participate in all of those things as well. We will sing the Lord's Prayer this morning, like we've been doing regularly. Communion is by intention. Come forward using the center aisle. Dip your wafer into the wine or the juice. Eat and return to your seat using the side aisle. This is the Lord's table, and the Lord invites all to come and dine this morning. Don't forget to sign the fellowship pass. I'd also like to point out that Bella Newman is not singing a solo on Song of the Shadows. Lynn Nature made a mistake in the bulletin. And she's singing a solo on In Pilate's Court, the Savior Stands. You'll know when she sings. She'll be the one standing up and her voice will be... Okay, I just wanted to point that out. A couple of other announcements then for you. This morning, right after the service, Chris Anders wants everybody to come downstairs to the west entrance because we unload the road home van and move in our road home guests. We make beds, we prepare the kitchen, so there's lots of things for everybody to be able to do. So come down and give Chris a hand. And then next Sunday, Easter Sunday, we load the van at 8:15 in the morning, so we need lots of hands again to roll the beds on and to put the personal belongings onto the van at 8:15 next Sunday morning. Easter breakfast will be going on, so you can do a little work, and then you can eat, and then that's a payoff for working and eating. In the entryway today, you can still sign up for a few things that the high school youth need for Easter breakfast. The jug is out to collect coins for the high school kids going to New York this summer. You can sign up for the senior brunch and euchre tournament over on the table. And don't forget to put your road home gifts down in the kitchen. And there was one other thing that I was going to tell people, and I forgot. You got the Lord's Prayer? Okay. Toilet paper. Who just said that? Thank you, Lynn. That's exactly it. Lynn and I think alike. Toilet paper. Next weekend, we collect toilet paper for the food pantry. So bring in your toilet paper. You'll be able to place it under the butterfly trees in the sanctuary. We're grateful that we can do that. Also, today is the final day to purchase butterflies for those trees or to give a gift directly for our project of assisting Jen Evans for getting her personal care dog trained. So take a look at that. Dorcas Circle, just a reminder, there's Dorcas Circle on Tuesday morning. We're celebrating Purim, remember? So we'll have a special Bible study, and we are supposed to dress up silly. So I said Tuesday, not today. So Dorcas Circle folks, remember to dress up silly on Tuesday morning for Circle at 9:30. Let us pray. God of the universe, you have given us the gift of salvation, and you have made that gift known to us in Jesus Christ. We are not able to express the gratitude you deserve, so forgive us when we seem aloof. Forgive us when we put ourselves before others. Forgive us when we fail to model Jesus, but continue to give us the will to try. Move us to work to end hunger and homelessness and to take a stand against poverty in our world. Open our eyes to the reality of oppression in our nation and state and make us do something about it. We pray for all people who have struggled with very difficult weather this week. Bring them safety. Be with all disaster relief volunteers and organizations. We pray for all people who are diagnosed with autism, and we give thanks for the stem cell research that can change their lives. Shower comfort on all who grieve. Bring healing to all who are ill, including Mary, Dakota, John, Jerry, Bertha, Twyla, Bill, and all those whom we now name in the silence of our hearts. Hear our prayer, O God. Amen. Thank you.
place where light and darkness meet, where light is obstructed. The prophet Isaiah wrote, "The people living in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the shadow of death, a light has dawned." And yet, against the light of the manger, the shadow of a cross was already forming. The light was shining, but the darkness could not understand it. The shadows began to gather. Jesus stood above Jerusalem. He saw a shadow of turning descending on the city and wept. As he entered her gates, the cheers of the people mingled with the jeers of his accusers.
Crucified.
Evening came, and the disciples gathered around their master for the Passover feast. While they were eating, Jesus made a startling revelation. I tell you the truth, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me. Each of them began to look at the other, and then within their own hearts, the shadow of betrayal swept through the room. Were they capable of such a thing? Saddened one by one, they questioned him. Lord, is it I? As Jesus broke the bread and poured the wine, the shadow of sacrifice weighed heavily in his heart. He told them, this is my body broken for you, and this is my blood spilled for your sins. Eat, drink, and remember.
Jesus broke the bread. Thank you.
Darkness took its final hold on Judas as he left the upper room. That night in Gethsemane, Jesus, burdened with sorrow, prayed alone. The shadows continued to darken. In that place of solitude and solace, a place Jesus loved, Judas returned. He brought with him those to whom he had sold, not only his teacher, but himself. The final affront came. He betrayed the Lord with a kiss, and the soldiers led Jesus away. Fleeing fear, the disciples abandoned him, and he was left in the shadow of loneliness. Darkness reigned, and it was night. Jesus and handed him over to Pilate. He was led like a lamb to slaughter. Silent as a sheep, before its shears. He stood in the shadow of suffering and said not a word.
Thank you.
loved darkness rather than light. And in the shadow of the cross, light and darkness came face to face. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Grant us peace. Creation groaned and wept as her creator died.